Hello and welcome to Not So Important History with T-Junkie. Today I'll be talking about the name of Not So Holy Roman Empire, but first we have to talk about empires. After the Roman Empire dissolved because of its own incompetence and something about 300 years later, Frankish Empire came. I can talk about Frankish Empire and not to mention Charlemagne, aka Charlie the Big Boy, the great man and one of the badasses which history will remember forever. Mention of Charlemagne? Check. After his death, crown passed to his son, and because he's not really important for this story, I'll just keep him to Charlie's grandson Lothar. Lothar had two younger brothers, Louis and Charles, which were not so happy about the rule of their brother, so they gathered some followers and went to war with Lothar. After 3 years, everybody had enough of it, so they met up in Verdun, divided the realm into not really equal parts, and called it a day. Louis got the eastern part of the empire, which became the HRE, so let's talk about that. After his death, and few decades later, Otto I revived the title of the emperor and proclaimed himself as successor of Charlie the Big Boy. And from now on, the confusion begins. Until 12th century, Eastern Frankish Empire was occasionally referred as Roman Empire. It wasn't that bad, because it held some lands in Italy, so we can see tiny connection to Rome, but in 1157, Frederick I Barbarossa, aka Freddy the Bearded, came. But first, I, as self-proclaimed historian, have to introduce you to Fred. He was really don't fuck with me or I slash your throat and pull out your spine kind of guy. Just look at him, you can see it in the eyes. He had also great beard, and because he's shown on the paintings with his majestic beard, I'll assume he was really, and I mean, like super really proud of it. Actually, he was so famous for his beard, part of his name is dedicated to the beard. Barbarossa is from Italian and it means something like red beard. Being a Holy Roman Emperor could seem to some as a really good position to be in, but you would have to deal with popes, and these holy men were constantly trying to fuck you over. Fred was having none of this anymore. He marched his armies to Italy, but before he could kick Pope's ass, Pope died, and the next one, Alexander III, kept fuck everyone, I'm the best attitude, so Fred appointed his own anti-pope, just to say, hey dipshit, I got new friend. He also renamed his empire to Holy Empire, to show everyone, you know, I've got a big G on my side. Unfortunately, he died, and in 1254 they thought, you know, it was fun and stuff, but we should do something with the name. So they came up with Holy Roman Empire, which like totally counts as new name. Fortunately for us, in early 16th century, it maybe seemed a little bit confusing, so the highest nobility of the empire met up in Cologne, to make sure everyone knows that they are not some bloody Italians. So they came up with Holy Roman Empire of the German Nation, because making a new name would be too hard. You can see there with brilliance, judgment, and other synonyms for intelligence which I quickly found on the internet. In the end, you may ask, what's wrong with him? Why was he talking about this? Or something else? And the answer is always the same. Dunno, just felt like I should. I think this is enough of me for one video, so if you like it, dislike it, or you have some other opinions, just leave comment, I would appreciate the traffic.